Let's have a look at limiting domain and even range, or both at the same time. So let's start with a calculate sticky, and I'm going to define a function. Let's define a function to be the sine of x. I'm going to define a second function. I'm going to define g of x to be sine of 2x. And I'm using my keyboard currently. So now I can solve an equation. So I'm going to type in the command solve, which you noticed comes up along the bottom. So I'm going to just go ahead and hit solve. And I'm going to solve f of x equals 1/2. And I get my solution and more solutions. I get a couple of different solutions here. So what I want to do is I want to solve g of x for the same thing. So I'm just going to recycle my previous equation and get my g of x solutions. Now I want to limit my domain for my solutions. Let's say I only want to look where we're looking between 0 is less than x, which is less than, we can go with pi over 2. So now my domain has been limited, so now you notice my solutions have changed. Let's do the same thing for solving for f of x and see what we get. And then we'll compare that same solution to solving f of x for the same thing, 1/2. And we can see how those solutions look different and how changing my domain has limited my function. Let's take a look at the graph of the same situation. So this time I'm going to create a graph. Create the function sticky. I'm going to move it up here. Get that out of the way. I'm going to go with y equals f of x. And then underneath it, in a red graph, y equals g of x. And we'll notice when I stretch this out, we get lots of solutions. You get graph going on to infinity in both directions. Let's just limit it to the domain of the function. So we want to be go between 0, which is less than x, which is less than or equal to 2 pi. And I can either use the word pi or the symbol pi here. It really doesn't matter. And then you'll notice that my blue function has shrunken down. So let's do the same thing for the g of x, which is sine of 2x. So we're going to limit it between 0, which is less than x, which is less than or equal to 2 pi. Now in my function, I'm going to zoom in so that I can see the difference between a function that has x and 2x and make some connections between those. Now I want to limit the function even further. I'm going to limit my function of g of x to its period. Its period is just pi. So now I get one full period. We'll notice that the heights are the same. We can click on the graph and find some important points and label those. Close those out of the way. Now this time let's limit the domain and the range, because you're going to actually limit the range as well. So instead I'm going to limit my range on my original function. I'm going to limit it between negative 0.5, which is less than y, and less than 0.5. Between 1/2 and negative 1/2, just on the y. So now when I graph it, I get just the parts that are within that range. I can do the same by adding a range restriction along with a domain restriction. So on the next one, on the sine of 2x, I'm going to limit that to be between negative 0.9, which is less than x, which I'll go less than or equal to 0.7. So now I've limited both my domain and my range on this function. You can eliminate your domain restriction and just have a range restriction. And then you'll see a different part of the graph. So there's lots of nice ways you can restrict your domains and your ranges in both of these functions any way you want. And you can do it in different places, in different areas. You can do it in your